guys. This is Joe, his guitar museum thing. You know me. And I'm here to talk about the Bonnie Strat and the set of pickups that we've recreated here. This is a 1955 hardtail Strat. You see, it doesn't have a tremolo. They made these. Robert Cray used them. I mean, a lot of people use hardtail. Ronnie Wood, you know, for example. And I got a call about 7 years ago from a friend of mine named Trevor Boone in Seattle. And he goes, man, I got the best Strat ever. And I said, boy, oh boy, that's a big statement. Send it to me and I'll check it out. And he was right. Look at him. He was right. See, I'm always doubting people. I should just be more trusting. Anyway, I've played this guitar on every record, every Black Country Communion record since I bought it, just about every live show. And it is the best damn Strat I've ever played. And it sounds, it has something different about it. There's an extra 5%. And I call it the Bonnie Strat because a couple years ago, I don't know if you could see it on the camera. Well, I'll twist it around, you can see it. Bonnie Bramlett carved her name into the back of the guitar because she was so nice and wanted me to carve my name into her guitar called Trigger. That had, you know, I mean, everybody from Clapton to Jimmy Hall. And I was so honored. And I was like, I wanted to return the favor. And she came and sang with us in St. Louis. And I was like, what guitar am I going to get her to carve her name? She brought her own Dremel and her penmanship is perfect. And I was like, look at it going, I'm never going to get rid of this guitar. It's a lifer. It's my favorite Strat. So she carved her name in the back, as we saw. And it's now called the Bonnie Strat. So the fine folks at Seymour Duncan have been nice enough to recreate the pickups and put them all in a harness and nice Bakelite looking knobs, and it sounds great. And we went back and forth about like 3 or 4 times just to get it right, because it's not an average set of pickups in this, and it's just whatever they put them in, you know, put in there in 1955, and it's the Bonnie Strat, forever to be known as the Bonnie Bramlett Strat. So enjoy. I hope you have fun messing around with the new set of pickups. They really do have that lovely mid-50s thing to them. And you can rule the world if you choose to. Hank Marvin Strat. Remember him? I love Hank Marvin. The English loved him. They painted all the guitars this color because of Hank Marvin. Anyway, we're here talking about the new set of Bonnie pickups. We just talked about the guitar, the Bonnie guitar, the 1955 hardtail. And this is the test guitar. So this has the final approved prototypes of the Bonnie pickups. Great thing about it is they sonically sound really, really close, if not identical. And honestly, I think the front pickup beats the original guitar. Don't tell the original guitar I said that. Oh, sorry. Features about the whole thing is you can buy the whole pickguard, and they got these really cool skirt knobs, the short skirt knobs, and the Bakelite is very convincing. I mean, it looks like mid-50s Bakelite parts. So when you put it on a, you know, a reissue Strat, like this is a custom shop reissue that was a gift from a friend of mine named Ian at Wild West Guitars. And we've been using this for the last year to develop these pickups. And it's a great Strat, you know. And so it proves that you can just drop these into a new guitar and it'll sound like an old guitar. You don't need an old guitar. So this is the new prototype set, which will be the new set of Bonnie pickups from the lovely folks at Seymour Duncan. Please enjoy. ¶¶